So I welcome Sri Anand on behalf of all the participants for the program. So let us enjoy the program in English today. Anand is there. So we can ask any question on this area. He will be able to explain in an interesting way. So those who want to ask the question, please raise your hands option. That procedure is there. I think by this time all of us are aware. Yes, Sanjay ji, you can ask question. Venkateshan ji, you can ask. Narayan. Venkateshan has come up with the question now.
Okay.
So I am giving an unmute.
Sure.
Yes, Venkateshan, now you can ask the question now.
Okay. Good evening, Babulalaya and Anandaya.
Yeah, hi.
Hi. Actually, I'm thinking what kind of question to ask. But one thing is coming. The thing is very clearly is coming that, if you look at the change, you know, we use the word change. Actually, everywhere, in spirituality, whatever may be, we use the word change. When we look at it, actually, when all the things, higher concept I went through, so the thing is that our body is changing. There is no doubt on that. From the essence moment that our physical body is born, is continuously changing. Each and every cell is changing. So that aspect is very clear. The other aspect is that when I went through Aya's concept, is very clearly that our sense perception also is changing. It is never be a same thing. If I see the picture of Babula Aya and if I see you, that our sensory perceptions are always changing. It is never be a permanent in one state. So it is always in a liberty state of our sense-perception. And then our mind also, because from childhood, all the information are stored in our mind. So we think that our mind is not changing. But actually, when we look at it, our mind is also changing at the core level. Yesterday, when we were discussing something, they were saying, at the core level also, there is a change. When Ajimani was saying. So in that case, that I also is changing. That means my question is that, is there anything that which never change? Because when we see the whole world, whole universe, everything is changing. So is there anything permanently never change?
Okay. So I think as far as we are concerned, at least in the psychological sense, so everything is changing. As you said, including the I, the identity or the self, which identifies with all these thoughts and emotions, even that is changing every moment because that I itself is part of the thought. Only when you have those thoughts, when you think about it, you will have that self-identity or you will have that I feeling. So even that changes every moment along with the thoughts. So there is nothing which is not changing only. Probably in the physical world, you can consider things as, which is at least to some extent, they are permanent so that you have to work towards correcting them and making it as per our requirement. So that's what
I'm getting I'm getting it very clearly. Yeah. The thing is that inner world and outer world. In an inner world aspect, there is no part for us. Everything is completely changing. There is no doubt on that. It's very clear. Because the thought which is coming is not at all is a new old thought. It's always a fresh one, new one is coming. There is no, when we observe very clearly. So, but there is no permanent I in as far as the inner world. But the external world, is definitely there is something permanently, but that also is a part of thought. But in the daytime, the moment we wake up, till the sleep goes to sleep, I feel that it's continuously there is only one I which is interacting to the whole world. Is it a connect?
Yeah. So that's how we feel, that's how it seems to us, but it is not, because, for example, if you are in deep sleep, you will not have that feeling of I, right? So only when thoughts flow, this thought process happens in us, then only we feel that I. So this thought only is creating this I also. As part of the thought, this I also comes up, I also appears. And then if the thought subsides, then I also subsides. So that's how it seems to us that, you know, there is a permanent I always, but it is not in reality. But in the external world is concerned, because it is, we are considering ourselves as the physical, you know, attached to this physical entity. So those activities, we have to consider that there is a permanent person, right? Because you were doing some activities yesterday, and then you have to, based on that, you learned some lessons, and then you can do it better tomorrow. So those things, we have to use it. That's more for practical, functional purposes. You don't have to confuse that with the psychological identity. So for us, the problem is more psychological identity, right? Functional activities in the external world is not a problem. That we should...
But when we are getting clear on the psychological world, then and ultimately it comes to the external world. There we have to see the permanent, is there any permanent guy, all the things. Definitely it is there, but as you said, it's only memory that when we sleep in the deep sleep, as you said, deep sleep, nothing, we don't know whether we are there. We don't remember our body. We don't know how the body is functioning, everything. So that aspect is very, very clear, Aya. There is no second doubt on that one, Aya, very clearly. But in that, for long I was thinking to ask you, Aya, generally see what we call death. I'm just asking to, thinking to ask you for sin. Because when thoughts are death, changing, our body is also changing. And one day that body is going to end, the function, the organism is going to end. So what it means by actually death, Aya? This question actually coming to me, that's why I'm asking.
Okay. So I think we discussed this before as well. So death is, of course, the physical body ceases to function. So that's what we generally call as death, right? Mm-hmm. Apart from that, there are theories about the astral body or the mind functions even beyond our death. And there are so many theories. But the problem is we don't have any scientific proof of any of that, right? So there is no point in debating or trying to see what is right and all that, because it will be a never-ending discussion, because there is no scientific or logical proof. I cannot experience it myself. So, you know, for us, I think, put it simply, yes, body ceases to function is the death. That's all we can consider. Whatever mind, whether mind works or whether there is an astral body behind this or not. So we don't know any of that, right? We don't need to worry about all that. Our primary, so those are all the secondary aspects, which, I mean, if you are interested, yes, of course, you can read books and read through so many articles and find out more. But our primary objective here is, first of all, the problems, the day-to-day problems that we have, and why are we getting psychologically stuck here? Know, how do we handle our mind? So that's where we get, how do we handle our emotions, feelings, thoughts? So that is where we are stuck. So primary aspect is that. Once you address that, I mean, then it is just for your own interest, you can explore all that.
Okay, I am getting clearly. Last time also same thing I asked. I repeated the question. I remember very well. Yeah. Okay, yeah. But in this, another thing yesterday we were discussing, I was trying to express what I am understanding. He was saying that about the interaction with the human being, like giving freedom and interaction and having the reservation and interacting with the people. So that one is very clearly, I got something understanding from Jeevamani era. Okay. That when we have freedom, give freedom to others to express themselves. So there will be a good interaction and it will be a very nice one. But when with the things is, it's naturally from our nature. It is actually coming up, we can able to see also. It naturally comes up when I see somebody. Immediately, the old memories is naturally popping up. So at that time, immediately we go back and we interact with the mind basis only. So that is naturally sometime happening. Sometime I am alert, sometime I am not alert. So when I am alert, that time okay. When I am not alert, you can take it easily. That is how it is.
No, actually, you don't need to be alert always, because if you have to be alert always, then it will be like a punishment, right? You will have to be always keep on watching every moment. So then it will be like a punishment. Then that will not be called as a freedom. You cannot call that as a freedom, right? So freedom here, what we say is you can completely ignore this whole psychological system. That is what is freedom, right? Then whatever comes, you are completely ready to accept everything, whether it is pain, pleasure, worry, sorrow, happiness, whatever it is, peacefulness, whatever you call as happening inside our system, psychological system, you're completely accepting everything. You're not even denying anything. You're completely in alignment with whatever is happening here. So that way, then you are completely free, right? Then you're no more bothered what is happening inside, whether am I worried now, or am I in pain or pleasure. So you don't need to worry about anything, whether am I alert now or not. All these are not required. You can totally ignore this whole system and then focus on the external activities. Then only you'll be able to freely. Otherwise, if you keep on watching every moment, then that itself will be a punishment, like a torture or a punishment beyond the point of time.
Yeah, I understand that very clearly. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Foundation. I'm muting you now. Next. Prem Kumar from Chidambaram has come. Okay.
Two people. Yeah.
Yeah. Chidambaram has
some
come.
Some more people have joined, I think. You can you can tell them that they have to raise hands if they want to ask. Yeah. Other new people also joined, I think.
Yeah. So those who want to raise the question or discuss with Ms. Anand, we have to use this raise hand options, which is available there in the system. One by one, we will be able to discuss with him. Now, Prem Kumar from Chidambaram has come up. I am giving unmute to him. Yes, Prem Kumar, you can talk to Anand.
Yes. Good evening, sir.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
So, I'm having one doubt, sir. By understanding this concept, I can able to understand everything. But the point over here is, when at one point, like the surrounding all makes us negative, like relatives' health issue, our folks are not going fine, and in all the directions, there are so many negatives. At that point, we can't be able to be strong to handle that, or we became so much bad, and we come to the conclusion that whatever we understand the concept, it's not working for us. Or when the negatives means the surrounding became so much negative, we also became so much negative according to that, and we try to believe that this concept is not working and we are not capable to do anything. We became like crushed. So how to handle this? I'm just confused. This thing.
Okay, fine. First of all, the basic thing that we are saying here, that you must have understood the concept, gone through those books, I assume.
Yes.
The concept here is that psychological system, all these emotions, thoughts, feelings are not under our control. There are two functions, right? One is the automatic function, like how our blood, our heartbeat, blood flow, and then our breathing. All these things happen on its own. We don't have any control over them, right? They happen on their own. Right. Similarly, in mind also, there is one portion, which is all these thoughts, emotions, feelings, etc. They occur on their own. They come up on their own, depending on the situation we're in. It suddenly, produces some emotion, some thoughts. That keeps happening every moment. There is the other portion in mind, where you can think, you can plan and do your activities, you can plan and do your work, going to office and so many other things, right? That's the second portion. Okay. We should just be very clear on these two things, right? In mind, there are two portions like this. And then there is an external world. External world, how do you should see, you should be able to differentiate between internal and external. External is whatever you are, others can only see your actions or your speech and actions, everything, right? Not your thoughts. So thoughts are not visible to them, or your emotions, etc. Only if you express, they will be able to understand, right? Okay. So as far as the external world is concerned, whatever you are expressing, wherever you are acting, only those are all external actions. Whatever is happening inside, those are all internal. You should be able to differentiate between these two. So, right?
Okay.
So external, anything may happen. External, it will, don't expect that it will be favorable. It will be always positive. Nothing. People will be there. They will be unfair. They will keep complaining. They will give all negative energy, or, they will keep doing all such things. So it is not under our control. External world, in the sense, you cannot decide what others have to do, right? They will do whatever exactly. they want to do. So you can, beyond a point, you can only do what you want to do or what you can do. So only that limited space. So internally, emotions and thoughts, they are not under our control because they trigger depending on the external situation. Suppose if others are talking in a negative way, obviously that okay. will tend to trigger some emotions here. So you don't have exactly. to be bothered by that, right? Because what okay. we are saying is, when you say it is not working, because there okay. seems to be a tone of that you're successfully able to manage, that's when you will call it as working, right?
Yes,
that's
yes.
what
yes.
you mean, I think, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Successfully
yeah,
able
yeah.
to manage, then you call it as working. But the problem yes. is even this thought of successfully being able to manage is also another thought, right?
Isn't yeah, it? Yes.
That I'm
yes.
able to successfully manage, or so that's also another thought. So even if you, okay. even after you understood, this thought comes, which means okay. that is not under your control. Even these thoughts also are not under your control. You should simply accept it. You don't have to question. Okay. Once you have understood the concept, you don't have to even question or ask, why is the mind asking this question? Why is it behaving like that? There is no need to ask okay. any such questions. Simply accept okay. and surrender. You cannot win over this. You have to get defeated. That's the whole point. If it is not working, okay. yes, accept that it is not working, because it is all psychological.
Okay. 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 Right. Nothing is in our hand. Even. Okay.
Yeah, psychologically, you have to completely accept everything. You cannot question, okay. you know, I have understood the concept. Why is all these emotions are still appearing to me? No, whether you have understood or not, emotions will still appear depending on the situation you are in.
Yes.
What we are saying is the concept itself is that we are accepting completely. We are giving a big tick mark to all emotions, thoughts, everything.
Okay.
This is how it will happen. This is what it, this mind's nature is this. That is what we are saying, right?
Okay.
So then
okay,
once you accept, then you cannot question that, right? Why is it happening like this?
Exactly, exactly. Sir.
If you question, then you're again going against the concept.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I understand.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
So, okay. So the another, what I understand, I just want to tell you in a very short way. This Sri Bhagavataya concept is like a modern kind of enlightenment, I feel.
Yeah.
In ancient days, people used to go for forest and they will make their subconscious mind clear and they will get enlightenment. Mm-hmm. They used to do this kind of things. But in the modern, we can't do that. We can't go to forest and we can't do all the yogas, anything. Mm-hmm. So this is a new method which helps to get even modern people. I literally
yeah.
feel.
Yeah, yeah, you can say so. This is more of a scientific approach. So those are okay. all, you know, there are different types of approaches, right?
Jnana yeah,
yoga
yeah, yeah.
and, you know, Bhakti yoga and Kriya yoga and
yes,
so many
yes.
other
yeah,
approaches.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is more of a scientific, a logical approach. We are using our intellect and trying to understand, okay. you know, where can we play a role, where we don't play a role. Just trying to understand okay. and differentiate that. That's all. Then the problem, because see, whether it, the problem is in subconscious mind or somewhere else, wherever it is, whether it is in Atma, awareness, consciousness,
okay.
whatever you call in all
okay.
those languages, but finally you are understanding everything, experiencing everything only through this mind, your conscious mind. That is the only thing which is visible to you where you can experience
okay.
anything, right? So you have to address okay. the problem here only, not anywhere else. All of that,
okay.
you know, it is of no use, right? But we have to address the problem here in our mind. So that is why we are directly addressing this point here in a scientific and logical way so that anybody can understand. Any simple, ordinary person can simply
okay.
understand this concept in a logical way and get benefited. That's our approach
okay.
here.
Okay, okay, sir. So the final question is, sir, if we want to do one work, for example, if we have a goal, and some point we are getting deviated from the goal. So to avoid the deviation or to be more concentrated on the goal to achieve that, because I am a student. Basically the student nature is to do something, because this is the time where we can grow up our skill and we come up with new knowledge and all. This is the point we
yeah.
have to do. In this point, there are so many distractions
yeah.
are available all over the world, like social medias or anything available. How we can be so much focused towards our work for getting up career-wise, how we can rise?
Yeah. So, see, our intelligence, all these emotions, right? Or once
okay.
our intelligence makes the decision, right? You have so many things. You have 2-3 things to do. So our intelligence decides, it gives the priority, right? Whichever is priority in your life, automatically your focus will shift to that, right?
Exactly.
That's what our intelligence decides. What is priority for me? If reading this or passing this exam or whatever it is, you know, or studying or completing the certification, whatever it is. So you have to fix that priority. If it is really priority for you in your life, right?
Okay.
If it is the topmost priority, then you will naturally try to, you know, focus on that more and give, you know, spend less time on other things. So you have to fix that priority. You have to understand and see what is priority. What is my first top thing that I want to do? Once you fix this priority, automatically your focus will, I understand, even though sometimes it may still drip away, but majority of the time you will still try to, you know, go in that direction. Once you fix that priority clearly. So you have to focus on, you have to first understand and fix your priority. Then you'll automatically try to go towards that.
Okay, I understand, sir.
Yeah.
For example, if I'm going to do some study, what is the importance of the study, how it is going to impact on me? I have to understand that, then all the distractions automatically by nature, it will go away. You're trying to say, right? Am I right, sir?
Yeah, if studying, suppose tomorrow, if you have an exam, then that will become the priority for you, right?
Exactly.
If you're very casual about it, then obviously you will not feel, you'll be feeling bored about it and all that, right? So you will have to fix the priority. But of course, I'm not saying 100% you have to focus, you'll be always focused and all. So that's fine. You have to accept that.
Fine. Okay.
If you start fighting with it, and, you know, then it will be a torture, right? You should not punish yourselves, you know, that you have to forcefully do something. But once you fix the priority, you have to try to do naturally whatever is happening in your way.
Okay.
Don't try to struggle or try to fight with that, because then it will only become more and more vigorous.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, Prem. Muting you now. Next, those who want to raise the question and discuss with Anand, and use raise hands option.
Okay. I think somebody is raising hands in the video. There is a reaction button. There you have to click that button, and then there is a raise hand option.
Okay, who was the person?
Krishna Sharma.
Okay, Krishna Sharma, I will open you. Okay, before that, Narayan from Chennai has given. Next to that, Krishna Sharma, I will open that up. Narayan, Chennai, I am unmuting you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good evening, Mr. Ananta.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
Yeah. So I had a few doubts, but most of them have been asked by Prem.
Okay.
So I was able to follow, but still, what I have is that to do these external, sometimes we do the things which we don't like. Maybe in the office we are working, but we cannot tell in the office that I like this or I don't like this. So we have to do it, right? So in that scenario, we'll get into some kind of struggle, and that again, it will go through all these cycles, right? We will take it to internal, then a moment we need to stop and we need to say that no, we should not bring it to internal, and we have to drill the problem. Instead, we have to work in the external. But here, the thing is that I'm not interested to do that. So in that scenario, how I need to handle it?
Okay. So first of all these internal, external, whatever I explained, it is more for analysis purposes. We are now trying to dissect something and then trying to understand how it functions, right? We are dissecting like how we dissect a body and trying to see what are the organs, how it functions. Like that, we are drilling down into our mind and trying to understand how various parts function, what happens here and all that, right? This in reality, in real life situation, you cannot do all this dissection analysis. So that will be like, you will be, it will be with the flow, right? It will happen within few moments, you know, you will not have time to analyze and all this. So what we are trying to say is only for analysis purposes. So what you should do, so what we are saying here, all these emotions, thoughts, feelings that come on their own, that appear on their own, and will also subside on their own. We don't have to do anything about that. Right, we don't have to take any responsibility, whether because of the external actions, if it triggers some negative emotion, some pain, frustration, sorrow, nothing, no need to worry about any of that, because we are not responsible. You have not brought them, right? If you have the choice to bring some emotions and thoughts, will you bring some negative emotion, painful emotion? No, right? you will only bring all positive, pleasant emotions, which means the very fact that all these negative emotion happens means that you have not brought them. We are not responsible for that. If we have not brought them, why are we trying to own them and trying to correct them? We don't need to. If you simply allow them, the next moment it is going to subside and it is going to die on its own. Problem is we interfere in this whole natural flow, this natural system which has already happened, and then complicating the whole thing. Like you must have heard this example, which we have told many times. If you take a bowl of water and there is water in it, still water, if you keep your hand and disturb that still water, then it will produce some waves and ripples around it, right?
Correct.
Now these ripples and waves are like emotions and thoughts coming, appearing in you. So now if you want to stop these ripples, what do you have to do? If you try and do something, if you disturb this whole process, then it will only create more ripples, more waves. It will be never ending. You will not be able to stop these ripples by your action. Okay. So what is required here is inaction. Just step back. Don't do anything. Just simply accept and simply step back. Don't do anything. Then ripple will settle on its own. If you don't disturb it, it will settle on its own within few moments. But if you start disturbing it, if you put your hand and trying to do something, then it will only complicate more and more and more and more. It will be never ending chasing, you know, never ending seeking that you have to keep on doing it. So same thing. That is why we are saying in mind, in psychological system, you don't have to do anything. Don't do anything. If you try and disturb that, it will only complicate more. Only in the external world, you have all possible actions. Coming to your, if you don't like work, etc. So that is what I think the same thing as I told Prem also. So if you fix your priority, like work, you know, whether I like it or not, you know, it is required for financial support and so many other reasons, right? Correct. Once you fix the priority, automatically you will start those energy or the emotions required, which will aid or which will assist your you know, what do you want to do, will automatically come up. You don't have to worry, you know, whether, and you don't have to also think about whether I'm having this interest or passion about it or not. You don't have to too much think about those things too much. Because once you fix the priority, once you decide that, yes, I have to work and I have to do all these things, this is my duty, then automatically, you know, those emotions will also support you.
Okay. So you mean to say that the moment we realize that there is nothing for us to do, that energy will channelize to do our external thing. Is that what you are saying?
Yeah, that's true. Because we are, most of our energy gets stuck here today. If we are struggling with this emotions, once this is free, automatically you will be able to focus more on that. And also you have to fix your priority. I mean, what is priority for you? Is it doing work or I want to do something else? That is your choice, obviously. But okay, if you feel something is important and you fix your priority, then these emotions and other things like passion, etc., will automatically come up gradually to your support, you know, whatever you've decided.
So you mean to say that everybody have that capability, right?
Yeah, of course.
So only thing is, since we are dealing with the psychological thing, we are not able to produce or channelize our energy to the actual thing.
Yeah, channelize our energy. And also you cannot wait for permission from your mind. You know, only when mind becomes calm, only when mind provides this passionate emotion, interest, only when mind supplies all these things, then I will go and work. No, you cannot, because mind is not under your control, right? You keep on saying something. Don't forget about it. What is your priority? I have to work. This is because of financial need or whatever requirement. Just go and don't even think about it. Don't even worry about it. Just simply have to go and do all that. Because here you don't have any option. There is nothing to do here inside.
Okay. Got it. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, Narayan ji. I'm meeting you. Next, Krishna Sharma. He was waiting there.
Yeah.
Okay. He is from Bangalore. I'm giving an unmute to him. Krishna Sharma, you unmute at your place. Then only it will match. I'm giving unmute. You have to unmute at your end. Sharma. Yes, now you have unmuted successfully.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now you can ask the question or discuss with Anand.
Anand sir.
Yes, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
See, I am 62 years old.
Okay.
I am retired as a additional secretary to Government of India.
Okay.
Practically, I am not having any financial issues or any other issues. Both the children are married. They are happily living. I am also happily living. What you have answered to Tempmar and Narayan, no doubt 50% of my doubts are cleared from that. But one doubt is still persisting in my mind. What if that one had been to the physicians? They had given, your problem is nothing but anxiety oriented. So use restil 0.25 mg or 0.5 mg if it is more trouble and you become calm. So whenever I am using the tablet, no doubt I am becoming very calm in my mind. Why I am not able to achieve the same thing in the meditation? Or through meditation, why I am not able to keep it for the waking time of my life? No doubt I will be working up to, also I will be reading up to night 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. But kind of serenity or the calmness I am not able to get in my mind. Please clarify.
So meditation is something like you're trying to fine tune your mind. You're trying to somehow shape up your mind in a way that you wish to, right? So meditation is a manual.
Yeah, to be calm.
Yeah, that's what you're trying to shape up as per your wish. However you want your mind to be, you want to fine tune your mind. So that's a manual. You're trying to manually tune it. So beyond a point, it will not, it will work on a temporary basis. You cannot find a permanent solution with meditation, right? Meditation and this enlightenment, that's a different
thing. It is my experience, sir. It is my experience.
Yeah, that is true.
It is my experience. Correct. Meditation will not give you the permanent cure. But what kind of thinking will change my mind?
No. So what we are saying is meditation, first of all, will not give you permanent cure. On a temporary basis, you can try to keep your mind calm and all that. So what we are suggesting here is a permanent solution. So, right, the concept, as we're saying, is a permanent solution. You don't have to worry about any of these thoughts and emotions. You don't have to try and keep yourself calm. It is not needed, is what we are saying, right? Because if you try and keep yourself calm, then the struggle will start because you're in conflict with your nature, the nature of this mind, which is naturally flowing. You're trying to change that. If you're trying to change the flow, then it will create conflicts and you will be in struggle always. It is like you're trying to catch your tail, a dog trying to catch its own tail, right? You will be keep on circling. There will be no, it will be an endless game. So that is why, so whenever it will be a keep on, you'll be always in struggle. Then you cannot be calm and peaceful, right? If you're always trying to do something, then you cannot be expect peace from that action. As I just explained, right, that water in the bowl. So how will you stop these ripples? These ripples are these emotions that you're saying. This once it is, if the water is still, that is what we call a peacefulness or calmful feeling that you're expecting, right? That water, whenever that water is still, that is the feeling that you're expecting. How can the water be still? Suppose some disturbance happens in the water. How will you revert back to that still position? By not doing anything, just simply taking off your hand, simply stepping back, not taking any responsibility to try and bring that stillness again. If you take responsibility to bring that stillness in this water, it will only complicate the whole process. You will again disturb this whole process because you are creating the problem. Naturally, everything's functioning perfectly fine. If you see from your childhood, a child will be in complete alignment with its psychological system. A child will not be in conflict with its psychological system. A child will not struggle against its own emotions and feelings and thoughts. It will never ask, if you go and explain that a child about enlightenment, liberation, meditation and all, he will not be interested in all this, right? He will simply be going with the life, flowing with the life, flowing with, his game, playing, playfulness or, his life, whatever is life happening for him. Whichever way it happens, because he is fully into it, he is not in struggle with the emotions. But whereas, because of our knowledge, we try to bring this under our control. We try to shape up this mind under our control, which is not required because naturally it is in liberated state. Naturally, if you allow the nature to flow on its own way, on own path, it is already liberated. but because of you trying to disturb, trying to do something, this liberation is getting disturbed. That is why you are getting all these, you know, emotions. You are trying to do something and get, you know, expectation, failure, disappointment, all such things are happening. So have I clarified it?
I will I will be reading some more. I'm not at all fully convinced, because the once you taste the silence in your mind, again and again we want it. Once you are, that the silence is getting disturbed in the mind, a little bit perturbed.
Yeah, that is the problem, right? Silence is disturbed in the mind means you are trying to take control now. You are saying, I want only silence. I don't want all these disturbance. I don't want frustration. I don't want angry. You are trying to give a command to the mind, which will not work because this mind is not under our control. It is like you are trying to control your blood flow. You are saying, I don't like 120 beats heartbeat. I don't like 120 beats per second. No, make it as 140 or 80. I don't like this. I don't like this breathing 80 breaths per second or minute, whatever. You know, you want to change that, but it is nature. You cannot change that. So similarly, mind also, you cannot give a command to the mind and say that I want only these thoughts and emotions. I don't want these thoughts and emotions. You cannot give a command to that. That's the problem. If you give a command, then you are in struggle with that. You are in conflict with that mind, and you will disturb the whole flow. That's what is happening.
Okay. But you have to give some kind of what I can say. You have to give me some kind of work how to keep it calm.
Yeah,
no, you are telling me, sir, not to deal with that one or not to react for it. In fact, I am doing all those things. But I am not satisfied.
Yeah, I am not satisfied is what? That's a thought or an emotion, right?
Yeah.
You're saying I'm not satisfied is something, an experience, an emotion you're experiencing, and you're just, it's a thought, whatever, you're just expressing that.
Because we have tasted the other one also. We have tasted the silence. That's why again and again, no doubt it is catching your tail, your own tail, like that you may be telling.
Correct.
But the thing is, the person who is experiencer here, I experienced something great. Why I am not able to get the same thing? What is obstructing me, I'm not able to understand.
Yeah, that is what you are only, it is our, we only abstract, because naturally you must have experienced, because somewhere you must have allowed the mind to flow, or it could be a real pleasure situation. Something in the external situation must have created some pleasure feeling or whatever. By means of meditation, it is temporarily possible. Yes. So those are all possible. But what we are saying is, if you understand the concept, maybe you can read the books, you know,
I'm reading.
Go through, you know, till you get complete clarity, you can go through again and again and again. So, you know, there is nothing wrong.
Yes,
so
sir.
You will, once you ponder over all these things, once you understand it on your own, then it will become your own truth and your own concept. Then things will work on its own.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sharmaji. So we can look for you for the doubts on this. So I'm giving a mute. Okay. Next, Sudhish ji from Lucknow. He is interested in asking question. I'm giving an unmute.
Yeah.
Yes, Sudhish ji.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening, sir.
I want to know, is love is an emotion? Is it an internal or external? We say that we have to be in love. We have to express love. Is it external or internal? Should we be in love, or should we allow it to be however the way we are?
Okay. Yeah. So I think I'm not sure if you've read these books and have an idea on the concept.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah,
you have an idea on the concept, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So psychologically, whether it is love or hate, whatever emotions, whether it is thought, emotions, whatever is happening beyond your control, whatever is beyond your control, in spite of, you know, you may think that I have to be loving with the love feeling, always smiling and all, but it may not produce that emotion here, right? So forget about here. We don't have anything to do here. You have to completely, there is no entry. You have to just put a no entry board here inside. You cannot do anything. It is not under our
control. That I know, but yeah. Thinking but that thinking that I want to be in love, is it correct or wrong?
So you don't have to have a rule that I have to be, you know, loving always and always smiling and receiving others with smile and all, because you may, it may not be possible always, but love again for the external situation, whatever is the right arrangement. Because if you have to get things done properly, then you have to be sometimes loving also. So rather than focusing on the emotion, whether I have to be loving or smiling or whatever it is, focus on the target or the objective that you have to complete, whatever work you have to complete. If you focus on that, you will naturally, you know, all these emotions or whatever emotions required to support you, it will automatically accompany you. You don't have to think about these emotions or the reactions that you have to do. How should I react and whether I should react with smile or not? You don't have to get into these nitty-gritties. You focus on the overall objective that you have to complete. All these things will naturally happen, because once you are fixed on the target, so you'll naturally do whatever is required. You will try to flow with the situation, and you try to adjust whatever is required for that situation, right? That's how it happens in everybody naturally. You don't have to try and do or, you know, plan for these things.
Not trying or planning. Thinking that I should be in love. Thinking, I'm asking, I should be in love. Is that thinking necessary or not? I'm asking. If I think so, will it disturb my enlightenment, liberty?
Okay. Two things here. First of all, whether I should think like this or not is not a question. Because thinking is something that you manually, you do for an external action, right? See, somebody is unmuted, I think. Okay. So, thanks. So, thinking is an external action, because why I'm saying is related to an external action. Because, see, there are only two things here, right? One is the external action, other one is the psychological stuff here. So here we have said that there is nothing to do here. So there is no need to think about the psychological system also, because we can't do anything anyway. No need to think about it. So you can drop all thinking thoughts, whatever you call, you can completely drop all these about psychological system. So whatever is left, what is left for us? Only external world. So you can only think about whatever you can do in the external world. Only that is possible. So if this loving, that I have to be in love, if it is related to your external action, and if it is going to help you in some way for your external action, then you can do that. There is nothing wrong about it. If it is not helping you in any way, if you are talking about only psychological portion of it, then you don't have to. You can simply ignore even this thinking that whether you have to be in love or not, even this thinking, whatever it is happening inside, you can simply ignore. Even after ignoring, if it is still happening, then it is not under your control. Let it be. Just simply ignore and focus on your external actions. That's all. And don't worry about whether it will disturb enlightenment, liberation and all. Because what we are saying is enlightenment is understanding that I don't have any role in this system, in this psychological system. That's all. If I don't have any role, whether it disturbs or not, then I don't have any problem. Let it do whatever it wants. Simply accept everything.
Okay.
Thank you. If any doubt, I'll come back to that.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you, Sudhish, very much. I am giving an unmute. Prem Kumar Chidambaram wants to talk to you. I am giving an unmute. Yeah. Yes, Prem Kumar, you can ask.
Hello, sir. One more question I'm just having right now is, what is your point of view about the discipline, sir? The term called discipline. Because I literally feel discipline is like which allows us to regulate our external activity to do properly.
Correct.
So that's what I'm just trying to ask. Matlab, by disciplined our work, whatever the concept right now it's available by the Bhagavataya will work in a proper way, I feel. So your point of view, can just tell something about discipline.
So as you rightly said, discipline in the internal psychological sense is not needed, because it can be any way psychologically.
Exactly.
It can be totally haphazard. You can be in a total mess also. We don't have to worry about all that, because we are completely closed here at psychological portion. So whatever we have left over is only the physical activities in the external world. So there you need discipline, because if things have to work, you have to be follow certain discipline, certain rules and regulations. Because suppose, yes, if you're going to a, say for example, a cinema theater or mall, anywhere, right? If everybody, yeah, just gets crowded, then you will not, if without, you know, standing in a proper queue, then it'll be difficult for everybody, right? Everybody will have to waste their, spend their time and unnecessarily stand there, and it'll be a total mess and struggle. But if you're disciplined enough and stand in a queue, and then you will be able to easily organize the crowd and take whatever you need from that place, right? Whatever is required.
Okay.
So discipline, okay, is required in the external world, right? So same way, okay, for everything, it applies for every situation, everywhere. If you follow certain, okay, discipline and rules, it will be comfortable to all of us, because we, yeah, have created, yeah, these rules for us only, for our own comfort.
Yeah.
Only. Yes, not, yes. Somebody has just, you know, pushed these rules and regulations.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Thank, yeah, you, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. I'm giving you a mute. Sanjay Srivastava.
Yeah.
Okay. He is from Bikaner.
Bikaner.
Yeah. Giving a mute. 1 minute. Yes, Sanjay, you can talk now.
Hi, namaste.
Yeah, hi.
It is not exactly a question regarding today's meeting. The title was given, pack up your worries, something like that.
Okay.
So I thought that it is a bit contradictory. Proper title could have been, there are going to be worries, don't worry about worry, something like that.
Yeah. I mean, of course we can do that. So point here is, at the end of it, if you ignore, and if you're by means of accepting this whole psychological system, all these worries are not going to impact you. I think as we discussed last week over phone also, all these worries are not going to disturb you at all. So it will simply by pass away on its own, like a passing cloud or whatever, right? It will not even disturb you. It will not even trouble you. So that way you are free from everything, all your worries once for all. So that was the objective of title. No questions, right? No, that for you. I think he has muted.
Sudhish ji has come. I'm not. Okay, Sudhish, you can ask the question.
One more doubt.
Yeah.
The behavior change or the habit, how can I form a habit or how can I make a behavior change of a person? How can I change my habit? Some habits, if I want to develop a habit of getting up early in the morning or something, I have to do something, some regulations in my life. So how can I do, how can, yeah, I proceed in that?
Yeah. Okay. First thing is, as we already spoke about, is fix the priority. If something is really priority for us in our life, then obviously we will tend to give more focus and more importance to that. If you feel that if you're not giving any priority, if it is not a very important thing for us, then obviously that importance level will come down and you will not be able to, you know, focus. You'll be very casual about it. That's the first thing. Second thing is, again, whether, see, what is the problem? Suppose I'm fixing that I have to get up at 5 o'clock every day and all. So maybe initially 2-3 days it will happen. After some time I will feel lazy, or it will say, okay, we'll do it later. So mind will keep on saying something, right? So if you want to take the permission of the mind, then only proceed to your external actions like waking up or going for a walk or going for a gym, etc. Then, you know, you cannot depend on mind for such things. You cannot depend on emotions for such things. You have to intellectually decide, okay, this is good for me. Let me do, whether the mind says or not, whether it creates that interest or passion or not. Don't worry about all this. Simply we have to go and do, that's all. It may not be possible. Of course, you may fail, you know, initially you may fail sometimes. That is fine. Try again. That's all. If it is not possible, one day you fail again, try it tomorrow. If tomorrow also, if you fail, try in day after tomorrow.
You have to go on trying it.
Yeah, there is.
We have to fix it and we have to go on trying it.
Correct. Don't worry about, you know, whether mind is supporting you or not, because you cannot expect mind to give you permission, and because mind will always go in the pleasure mode. It will not accept.
Sir,
Yeah.
1 minute.
He's in mute now.
Yeah. No. I have given the mute because there was some disturbance. I'll release it.
Things in Shabrimale and all, when we go, we have a mandalam, one mandalam here to go without slipper, so that it will make an habitual change.
Correct.
Is it possible here also for 41 days if you follow this one? Yeah.
I mean, it need not be 41 days also. You don't have to torture yourself that way. What I'm saying is, if you fix that, this is very important for me, then obviously you will give more focus and more priority. Second thing is, don't worry, don't ask permission. Don't try to wait and wait for the mind to give you permission and give you the right emotions to support and all. Don't wait for all that. Simply you have to go and do. You may fail sometime. Yes, just don't worry and try to do it again. That's all. That's the only way. Because in the external actions, whatever best possible, we have to keep on trying. There is no formula, right? You cannot say that today I decide and I should, from now on, I should be perfect in my external world. That's not going to happen.
Sudhish, I think, Lion got disturbed, I think. Sudhish?
Yeah, let him connect back. We can go to somebody else.
Okay. So I am muting him anyway.
Okay, yeah.
It's not getting connected. Maybe some line problem. Maybe there. Anybody wants to ask the question or raise the question, raise their hands, please. Sendil from Singapore, he wants to talk to us, so I'm giving an unmute.
Yeah.
Sendil, yes.
Okay, good evening, sir.
Yeah, hi, good evening.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, okay. My question is related to the previous two questions. I joined a bit late. So my question is related to that. Once we come to this understanding, for example, there's nothing much I need to do internally. Whatever I need to do externally, I just need to manage those actions. Now, considering that, activities, for example, I procrastinate things instead of doing it today. It's because that either I am afraid of doing that stuff or there are some underlying reasons that really makes me to delay. So in such procrastinating things and other activities, whatever I do, that those things have to be managed externally. So that discipline, the question earlier Prem asked, the discipline has to be managed by me and on my own. So the understanding alone does not or it will not change my external action. Is my understanding correct?
Yeah, I mean, you cannot expect yourself to be perfect from, that tomorrow onwards, you're going to be perfect human being in the external world. Because external world, there are some limitations. Your body may not agree, may not be in line with, you may say that I'll get up 5 o'clock, go for a walk every day, but your body may not be in tune with that. So it may take some time. You have to only keep on trying various options, try different methods. Take some suggestions, try, for things like, for example, join a club, club of people who are doing it regularly. So you will also get some interest, not because of walking, at least to, have a good chat, nice chat with them. So those things, I think you can try and do all that in the external world. Internally, as you said, yeah, psychologically, there is nothing else we can do. Once you understand this, then you will be more, you will have all this energy and focus, attention towards the external world. So that should definitely help you. Be more efficient in the external world, but you cannot be expect that you cannot expect that you will be perfect in everything.
Okay, sure. Thank you. So, what will be the obvious outcome? For example, I have this understanding, the clarity around. Okay, there's nothing much I can do internally. But what will be the obvious outcome? That I can see. For example, now what will be the difference from my previous state, the post understanding state? So if you could clarify that, it would be helpful.
Yeah, sure. So the main thing is, before understanding, all of us must have been carrying all these emotions and thoughts, owning up that I am responsible to correct all these things. So it would be like a heavy baggage that we'll be carrying, like a 50 kg of baggage. If you're carrying always on your back, whatever you do, eating, sleeping, working, you're carrying this heavy baggage. It's tied around your neck, for example. then that will be the heaviness you will feel, right? Always you will be in torture, you will be in stress, you know, frustration, whatever. In between the moments, you will be happy in between. But most of the time, your underlying background will be always that stress and frustration will always be there because you are carrying this baggage and fighting with it. So what we are saying now, you don't have to carry that baggage because it is not yours. For example, I'm saying if it's not your baggage, you know, please drop. You don't have to take responsibility to correct them or keep them in the right shape. It is not your responsibility. Don't bother and just drop the baggage. Whether the baggage exists or not, don't worry. Because this is not your, you are not responsible for this, is what we are saying psychologically. So once you drop the baggage, you know, you're free, right? All your energy that you're always, it was on your back, that baggage was always on your back. Now you're free to move around. Now you're free to do whatever you want with more energy. So which means you will be more efficient. You'll be more optimistic. You'll be able to perform in a better way. But only thing is, you cannot expect that you'll be a perfect human being. You may have some imagination. That is not possible, but you will be obviously more efficient. More energy will be able to spend in your external activities. So that way you'll be more efficient. And psychologically, you will not be have anything to worry about. You will be completely free from inside, right? It is like, you know, suppose you have to write an exam, a medical exam or something like that. You are like struggling for, you know, 1 year, you're preparing for a NEET exam, for example. And suddenly you're coming to know today that, for you know, you've understood this. You don't have to write any exam. You're free. We are giving you free seat, for example. You don't have to study at all. Then you'll feel that freedom, right? So that freedom is what we are, you know, we are giving here, right? By means of this concept, you can throw all your emotional baggage. You can drop all your emotional baggage. You don't have to carry it, is what we are saying. So that's the freedom that you get here in psychological
sense. Okay, sure. So that will come over a period of time. Yeah. Yeah. So it's because, for example, now I was listening to you, but halfway through, I started thinking something else. Then I had to drag myself in and then continue to listen to you. So the background thoughts are always happening there. So the focus I need to bring and focus my attention to your answer. So just because like I am not doing anything internally, but it's still the thoughts are flowing continuously. So the external action is always like bringing the attention again to a subject that I am on is still required. So, like, if you ask me whether I have that freedom of the feeling of freedom, I'm not 100% sure whether I have that now. So I'm not sure that will happen over a period of time. So I just take that with a pinch of salt. Yeah, okay. I just understood that there's nothing much I can do. But perhaps as I move on, perhaps I could. This process could be an automatic process there, the thoughts come and go on their own, but if I need to focus, I just would that be the case or no?
Actually, yes and no, a little bit in between actually, because one is I will suggest that you go through the books and videos, whatever you're following. I think you must be reading some books or videos, right? Go through that again multiple times, because sometimes, you know, because it is more than what is said in the books. More important is what do you feel about it? How do you see this is what is more important, because only when it strikes, when you see that, yes, I don't have to do anything, that, you know, you should have that experience or you should have that feeling that, yes, you know, this is correct. Yes, I'm also seeing in my own psychological system. Yes, it works this way. I don't have to do about it. This frustration or anger, whatever you said, that feeling, procrastination or that feeling, which is not coming, means some negative emotion, right? Some feeling of lack of, some dissatisfaction or lack of fulfillment, something like that, right? That feeling is there. That's also an emotion, right? If you simply allow and don't disturb, don't do anything, it will go away on its own. Once you see this on your own self, on your own experience, then you will not ask this question because it is already solved. Problem is already solved. Where is the problem? Only if there is a problem, then I have to ask a question to solve it. I'm saying there is no problem at all because it is already dying on its own death. You don't even have to kill that. You don't even have to rectify that. It is like waves. Waves in the sea or ocean, whatever. Waves will rise up and it is already going down. You are actually realizing that there is a wave only on its way to its death. It is almost going, dying its death, and you are recognizing that only at that moment. So if you just allow it, it will automatically die its own death. That's how it is. So what I suggest is you go through these books or videos again and again multiple times and try to understand what is being said, whether it fits in your logic and all. Try to do all sorts of experiment and analysis here. So once that will help you to come to a conclusion.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Hey, thank you very much, Sandil. Then Vivek Krishna from Delhi is waiting. I'm giving an unmute. Vivek, you unmute at your end. Yes.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, hi, good evening.
Sir, my question to you is, you know, there are moments where you have to deal with certain kind of people who are extremely cunning and narcissistic in nature. But you deal with them and, you know, you have no option to run away from them because they are your relatives, they work with you, they are your friends. And so my question to you is, why is there a need in me, you know, a want in me to change them? To want them to be in a certain way, you know, which is not hurting me. And you know, I lose my mental balance when I deal with certain kind of people.
Your voice is breaking. Maybe some problem with your mic. Or there is a disturbance.
Sir, is it clear now?
Yeah, this is better, much better.
Okay. So that is my question. Like, you know, when dealing with certain kind of people, you know, I lose my mental balance. Yeah. You know, there is a, you know, need in me to change them, want them to be in a certain way. So, you know, how can I be peaceful from inside, you know, dealing with them? You know, what is the way to deal with certain kind of people? That is my question.
Okay, fine. So the problem is here. So you want to change them. See, always we are, I think, from the childhood or whatever, we have always been conditioned like in the external world, if you try and do something, if you alter the situation, then you will be happy. If you, right from, you know, for example, from the schooling, like once I'm out of this education system, school, then I'll be free. All this torture from teachers and parents, I'll be free. Once I'm out of this college, then I'll be happy on my own. Then once I get a job, then I'll be free. So like this, it keeps on, we are endlessly chasing that by trying to do alter something the external world. Once I get a job of 10,000, then I'm going to be happy. And after some time, after 2 months, then, you know, no. Once I get achieve 20,000, then I'll be happy. Once I reach 50,000, 1 lakh, I'll be happy. Once I get married, once I have children, once I have buy a house, car. So like this, we keep on chasing this endlessly in the external world. We are trying to change something in the external world, which should then trying to achieve peace or satisfaction here. So we are looking at the wrong end of the problem. The problem is not at the external world. I mean, problem is not there because it will be endless possibilities in the external world. You cannot try and change something and create happiness here. That will be only a temporary measure because this desiring or this seeking pleasure is the quality of your mind. You know, these thoughts, and that is your nature. So if you try and whatever you try and correct in the external world, it is not going to end. It will be an endless journey indeed. So you have to come first of all here. You have to try and understand what is happening here. Why am I like this? Or you know, what are these thoughts, emotions? Why is it happening? You have to try and understand this whole mind. How is it functioning? What is my role here? You know, where can I do? You know, what are the do's and don'ts? How it works? So if you try and understand here, then you will get you will be psychologically free. That is what we call a psychological freedom, that we as part of this concept. Once you're psychologically free, then you will be absolutely clear on what can be done in the external world and what cannot be done. You will be in complete clarity. Then you can deal whichever way you want. So people, of course, you cannot change people, right? Because see, your mind or these thoughts, etc., you are living with that from your birth, whatever your age, 30 years, 40 years, 30 years or 40 years, you've been living with that. So mind is not listening to you. Your own mind is not listening to you. Your own thoughts are not listening to you, right? You cannot expect others to listen to your theories or your philosophies or your commands or your wish list, right? They will be in their own conditioning. They will listen to, they will only react from their own conditioning, their own nature. So you cannot expect that everybody will have to react according to your wish. So that will be there. People will be there. That's how the situation will be. External world, hundreds of situations will be there. But if you are clear inside, once you know how to handle this system, which we have with our own system, then you'll be able to easily address in the external world.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So you should focus more on understanding this system first.
That's exactly. I just wanted to ask this one question. Like, what do you mean when you say understanding? Because when I read a book, you know, I intellectually understand what is written in the book. But when I apply it into my real life, I understand it experientially.
Yes.
So how to bridge this gap between intellectually understanding and experiencing in reality?
Yeah. So, okay. Have you read any of the book, this concept?
Yeah, is
this
yeah, I've read these books.
Okay, fine. So probably you can read it again and again. So here, this concept is more of an intellectual concept only. There is no need to experientially see anything. All that is not required. If you simply, because what we are saying here is a logical, it's a scientific process. What we are giving, what we are explaining here is a scientific phenomenon. It is not something that, you know, that you have to practice for 20 years, that you have to believe in some spiritual concepts or some theory, some religion. Nothing of that is needed. It's a simple scientific fact. If you throw a ball up, right, it will fall down. Right, that's its nature. So it is very similar to that. Mind, this is the function of mind. Mind is will keep on giving some options. It will throw some options, throw some emotions, thoughts at you. Only if it is useful for your external action, you can pick some of them, pick one of them and use it. If at all, if we need anything, if you don't need to do anything, simply you can ignore. Because that is the job of the mind. Mind functions that way. You don't have to react or take responsibility for whatever mind gives you. You don't have to be responsible for that. That is what we are saying, right? You don't have to handle anything. Here we are saying drop everything. You don't handle anything. Just simply, you know, simply step back and enjoy, relax is what we are saying, right? You don't have to do anything. It is inaction. Undo is what we are saying here, right? That is the language we are saying. But our mind understands only in an action language. So that's why we are trying to convert this, even this philosophy into some action and we are trying to do something. That's the problem. Okay. So we are not asking you to do anything. We are asking you to not to do anything here.
Okay, sir, my last question to you is, sir, what is the role of self-affirmation, visualization in, you know, molding our mind? Like, you know, in Western psychology, they speak about think about yourself in greater terms. You know, athletes use them. So how can it help in, you know, shaping our attitude? Like, what is the role of self-affirmation? Is it really useful or not? That is my question.
Yeah. So it can be useful in the external world activities. Suppose, you know, if you want to do something, you know, you are imagining about what should be done. How can I do it better? You know, what are the things I should do in a better way? So imagining about all that and thinking about that for the external actions, it could be helpful sometimes. You know, I don't know what are the techniques that you're talking about, but if it is useful for your external action, that is obviously, you know, you can always do that if it is helpful. But don't do that. Try to do that in the internal, our psychological system, because there is nothing to correct here is what we are saying. There is nothing to rectify here because it is all, we are giving a big tick mark, big acceptance to everything here inside our system. So you don't have to do anything here. Okay. Don't take any role. Only taking role is a problem here.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vivek. I'm muting you now. Venkateshan, Nigeria, he is waiting. I'm giving an unmute.
Yeah.
Yes, Venkateshan, you can talk now.
Yeah. When we are discussing something pop up to ask, you said that our peace of mind, which is actually a natural one, which each and everybody, we have it naturally. But before somebody was asking, the person, Vijay was asking that, Vijay or somebody was asking, this peace of mind which we have already will be disturbed by our intellect, which is always disturbing this one. So now this peace of mind which is already with us, we don't need to retain. What is the understanding I'm getting from you is that your speech is that is the one I'm sharing to you. So this natural peace of mind which we have already, so we don't disturb it. Actually, we look for it, this peace of mind, by external activity. like doing things, all the things which we do externally. That, as you said, externally it will give us the peace of mind in a temporary manner. But which is already the peace of mind, which is naturally which are with us. I'm wrong to ask that question. It's popping up in my mind naturally. That is wrong to ask how we can bring that peace of mind naturally to us.
Okay. First of all, peace of mind means what disturbs your peace. For example, you expect something to happen. Just for an example, we can say, you expect some action or some result in the external action that you did. And if it is not happening according to your wish or according to your expectation, then obviously it creates some disappointment, some frustration. That is the lack of peace of mind, right? So only if it happens according to your expectation, you consider that as a positive or a happiness or whatever, right? Only if it not happens according to your wish, then you consider that as a negative result, negative outcome. So that is the problem here. So in the psychological sense, you're expecting that mind should work in a certain way. You're having a wish list that mind should only produce these emotions in these conditions. No, you're having a list actually. You're having a rule book inside, right? If in this situation, I should have only these 1, 2, 3 emotions and thoughts. You're giving a command to the mind. And in the next situation, I should have these 4, 5, 6 emotions and thoughts. You have created such rules inside your system. So now, if it is not acting according to your rules, it creates a disappointment. It upsets that peace or whatever you call that self-satisfaction or whatever that stabilized state of mind, right? It disturbs that because it is a disappointment. It creates a disappointment in you. So what we are saying now here is we are trying to understand this functioning of mind, and we are saying that mind will never obey your rules. These thoughts and emotions will not obey your rules. You have created some rules on your own without understanding this, how this mind functions. Then mind cannot be, cannot react as per your expectation, right? So what we are saying is drop all the rules. Don't carry any of these rules. Mind will keep on functioning on its own way. It will trigger some emotion, some thoughts on its own. It will not act according to your expectation. So once you drop that expectation, then there will be no disappointment, no pain, pleasure, both. You're accepting both, right? So once you're accepting both, then there is no friction here. Only friction creates some kind of a suffering or some kind of a conflict, right? That is what you call as pain or lack of peace. Whatever words you use, whether you call it as peace, satisfaction, pain, sorrow, whatever you call, finally it is the friction which creates pain. If it is in line with your expectation, then it creates the positive emotion. Once you drop both these, you're okay with both. Drop means you're not dropping anything physically. You're saying, I'm accepting both. I'm not going to deny or dislike anything. You're accepting both. Then you're not in conflict with anything. You're in sync with the entire flow that is happening inside. And there is nothing which is going to cause disturb your peace. So that's how peace is retained, is what we can say. Instead of peace, the right word will be liberation, because you're already liberated. Natural flow is liberated. You are disturbing the liberation because of your own wish, expectation against about your mind, your psychological system. Expectation, liberation will be naturally there, always there.
Very clearly. When I am hearing your talk, something very clear understanding came to me now. Mm-hmm. But for long, I hear everybody, Bhagavata, everybody. Now, I don't know, I got it very clearly. That understanding, cannot say I got it. The understanding has come. So now when we see this mind is completely, is already liberated. All the things you are saying very beautifully, you said. I don't know, something happening in me that is changing. I don't know what to put it in words. Because sure. we are always discussing in the words. Sure. But the change, it is not in the word level. Something happening when I'm speaking to you, something happening. So I'm very happy to be in the, this is a natural expression I am expressing. I'm sure. Very happy to be in our Bhagavad mission and let this goes to all over the world, this one here. I'm very happy for this. I'm very, very happy to be a part of this family.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. I'm meeting you now. Next, Raghunath from Qatar.
Okay.
He is waiting there. I'm giving an unmute. Raghunath, you have to give unmute. Yeah, he has given. Right. Yes, Raghunath.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, both of you.
Oh, good evening.
Good evening. Sorry, I don't have that video, so I will start from only audio. Sir, just I wanted to understand what is the guilty conscious or unfulfilled desires, and if it is running background, and sometimes we are coming out, but most of the time if it is running, means what is the? Can you give some? What is the role? How to come out? You understand my? This is my question.
Yeah. So have you read these books and concepts already?
Yeah, I understand. Even I some Bhagavataya's speech also. He's saying that that thoughts also it will come and go. You need to respond it. He said, and it's okay. It is happening some, but still somewhere it is occupying some unfulfilled desires or the past mistakes or some guilty conscience. So we wanted to overcome it. Just I wanted to hear from you some explanation. That's okay.
So when you say overcome, so are you meaning that these past desires, these unfulfilled desires should not come in you?
Yes, with the present work it is come and immediately background it is running. It is sometimes it is before coming to this Bhagavad session, we understand that always the mind is occupying our it is related to mind body also. So it was always the mind related, the mind was always occupying with that inner chatting or anything. It was there. Now we want to separate it. Sometimes it's occurring now. Still now it is coming now. So we want to eradicate fully. We want to leave it as it is, like liberation. Like, so in that sense, somewhere it is still coming, and one or two days it is getting stuck.
No. So that's what I think I explained to somebody else also. So mind always understands anything in the form of action. Even if I'm telling you don't do anything, so you are like asking, how do I not do anything? How do I practice not doing anything? Is what you're trying to ask.
No, I'm ignoring that one. Even if I work something there, it's coming there background. Even though I'm trying to ignore it, still
So that is the problem. You don't trying to ignore means you are creating an action there again, right? So we are saying don't try and ignore anything. Don't do anything is what we are saying. If it comes, accept it. That's how its nature. Simply accept. Okay. Only by accepting it, you are allowing it to flow, right? If you are trying to do something, you are against it. You are fighting it. That's what it means actually. So
you are right. So I'm fighting internally that what if the we learned from that mistake? We wanted to change. Now it's up like that. I am counter reacting with that one. Okay, so it's happened. Now we wanted to do some counter action to be taken to in the present life like that. Some expectation I'm putting on this against that one. Then it is going on like that. Understand?
Yeah. So don't fight against your thoughts and emotions. That you cannot do anything. Simply accept it. Don't try and do anything. Only in the external world, actions, if you have a scope to rectify, in the past you must have behaved in a bad way or something. If there is a scope to rectify now, you can do it in the external action. Don't try and do something with your emotions and thoughts. Don't go against them. That's the problem.
Okay. So, example, it is if it is the case, in the cases, it is very, very near relative, and they did good for us for 25 years. I wanted to do it good in that way, something to, I wanted to take care them in a better way, while thinking that when it is not reached. Actually, it is my duties to do that one. In that duty, I made it different types of varieties because of I can do it like that. But it not reached it. And in that way, I got angry. So because of they are not accepting and they are not coordinating like that in that way. But what I mean to say, that relation I cannot keep away. I cannot keep go near also. So in that situation, that is playing my role.
Yeah. So whatever in the external situation, whatever action happens in the external world, it will keep on producing some emotion. Emotions are only a reflection. Like how if you see the mirror, if you go in front of a mirror, then mirror will simply reflect what is in front of it. if you keep an ugly or a, you know, full of dust, a dustbin, then it will show only dustbin. If you keep a good food items, you know, nice items, good looking, nice items, then it will show all that only the mirror. So mirror's function is to simply reflect what is there. That's all. You cannot question mirror, why are you showing? Even though I keep some ugly or some dustbin, you have to clean it, and you know, mirror should do all that. You cannot expect that, right? So mind also will show whatever is reflecting, whatever is that happening in that situation, it will keep on showing you. It doesn't mean that you have to take everything and work on it. So simply, if you don't do anything, it will automatically, you know, next image, once the image changes, that it will give a different image now. Once the image changes, mirror also changes the image, right? Mirror doesn't have any control. It will just simply reflect whatever image comes in front of it.
Okay.
You cannot change these emotions. Simply try and do whatever is action. If it is in the external world, whatever action possible, you can focus on that and try and do that. That's all.
Okay. So whatever the negative thoughts which I created by own, also if I see them, it will come automatically. Then I have to ignore it. Still, I have to go with them and make them happy. Moment.
That's the only option, because mirror, it is like a mirror. Mirror will keep on reflecting till your last breath. It will keep on reflecting whatever comes in front of it. So you cannot expect that mirror will be clean. Whatever object I kept here, keep here in front of the mirror, mirror will be always clean and calm. No, not that. You cannot expect. Mirror will be like that.
Okay. Like if we put more salt, more water, dilute like that, we don't have any to dilute it. I'm trying to dilute it with something.
Yeah, the problem is when you try, you know, that is the problem. You're trying you're against it actually. You're working against it. Then you will only complicate the matter and you will only make the problem bigger. Rather, if you step back and don't do anything, then it will automatically go and balance. It will come to a balance on its own. Our mind will come to a balance on its own.
Okay. Well, now what happened? Now my old meditation techniques are coming and it is coming in front to dilute it. So that's happened. Now I understand. So that means it is coming my old system and it is coming to suppress it actually. So even though that also I don't want to try, correct?
Yeah, don't do anything. Yeah. All that will come because that is the nature. That is the job of your mind, no? Function of your mind.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you, Babla, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, Raghunath. Okay, I'm meeting you now.
I think somebody raised hands, right? Krishna Sharma or somebody.
Krishna Sharma, you want to ask question?
Yeah, once again, sir.
Please.
Sir, Anand, sir.
Yes, sir.
Just now you answered Anand. I do like it. The main problem is if the fight or not fight, external fight, whatever you say, it is with your beloved and the life partner, your wife, my wife. So we are not able to control that emotion in whatever fashion we are trying. All the difficulties are going round and round. For the 38 years I married, and what I have understood, I am feeling bad for it. Okay. How to control it?
So, control here means that you want to your mind or emotion to act according to your expectation.
Sir, I cannot change here. That is one thing sure. Yeah. Okay? I have to change myself to become calm myself. Uh-huh. Because who is the sufferer? I am the sufferer. Uh-huh. She is not feeling that suffering. She is only simply fighting and going away. But finally, I am the sufferer. So, I want to get rid of my suffering by keeping my mind calm. So, what logic can work for me? That only I want.
Yeah. So that is what the logic is. So the emotional part of it, it is not under our control. We already discussed that, right?
Yes.
So whatever, as I just explained, in front of the mirror, whatever image comes in front of the mirror will simply reflect. That's the job of the mirror.
I agree, it sir. Only thing is when the love partakes all those things, you are not able to control. The internal love for a person or internal love for the thing, because maybe we lived so much, so closely and so intimately, we are not able to digest that kind of differences.
Yeah. So emotions means, all these emotions, when you say you're not able to digest, you're not able to accept means it's an emotion that you dislike, that agreed. You don't like, right?
Agreed.
Yeah, so that's what we are saying. Emotions will not be as per your wish and expectation. You cannot, whatever you do, you will not be able to do anything. Only if you accept your failure and stop fighting with it, you're allowing it to pass away.
But it is like, leading to depression, sir. It is leading to depression. The moment I accept the emotion without responding at that time, if I am becoming silent, yes, I am not fighting with my emotions. I am not fighting with the external affairs. But what I sensed it for the last 2 years or 1.5 years, definitely it is leading to the depression.
Yeah. So actually, so fighting means you should probably try to understand that in a more detail. So the objective of this question itself, for example, you know, that this emotion, how to handle, how do we handle this? I'm getting affected, depression, etc. The objective of this question itself is that I don't like the current status of my psychological state. I want to change it as per my expectation. That's the underlying objective of this question, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, which means you are fighting against the natural flow of your psychological system. Am I correct? Yeah. You don't like the current state. You want to change it.
Because it is affecting your physical health.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we don't want to fight. Because it is affecting your physical health, I'm against this kind of thinking.
Yeah. That's what, even this physical health also, it is affecting because, to some extent, because it is, you are creating a friction. There is a struggle and constant struggle which is happening inside. All your energy is focused on handling this psychological system and you are in complete struggle, continuous struggle. So your entire energy is spent up here, right? So only when it is released, once you are free from this, your energy can be spent on other things. So it may also have an effect on your physical health also sometimes. So what I will suggest is you understand this, like how the psychological system functions, what can be done. So that if you give more focus to this for the time being, forget about the physical thing actions now. For the time being, if you more try to understand here, once you are free, once you are clear on this, I think then you will be able to handle your external things in a much better way.
Any IAS teaching or any book, can you refer for me to
yeah,
book,
I will,
deep into it?
Sure. Yes. I think you will definitely have to go through those books.
Because any particular more book, if you are telling, I will go through it.
Sure. So are you in the WhatsApp group? I'm not sure. Or you can
send
me a message.
No, I'm not in the WhatsApp group. Let Babula or somebody join me in that WhatsApp group, sir. Because I don't know what is that group number and other things. Sure. I had given my mail ID and everything like that.
Sure. We will send you some books or you can give you a number also. I can also send. Or
yeah, number books I downloaded. I think last time one lady has sent it to me.
Okay.
So I had got that books. Only thing is I'm not there in that WhatsApp group. Whatever you are discussing, I'm not.
You just write your number in the chat now.
I will write now itself, sir. I will
Right now we will add it.
We will get you added. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Krishna Sharma. I'm meeting you now. Sudhish from Lucknow again. He's waiting. I'm giving an unmute.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. I had an interruption in live current.
Yeah.
Sir, while you are speaking to Vivek Sharma from Delhi, you said the natural tendency of the mind is to seek pleasure. Seeking pleasure.
Correct.
So if it's the natural tendency, why should we avoid it? Why should we not go through the pleasure?
Yeah. Yeah. So that's the problem we are all stuck with, right? If you go behind that, obviously everything, whatever you do, it will not give you pleasure, right? There will be 50% of time it may give you pleasure. I mean, I'm just giving a number. It could be 30% of time it will give you pleasure. 70% of time it may give you pain also. And it will not happen to you, whatever external situations or actions, it may not happen according to your wish or your desire. You can chase, but the outcome may not be always positive. And it will keep on creating pain. So that is where we are stuck, right? We don't want pain. So we are trying to solve that problem, right? We are trying to see what is the solution to all these problems that we are facing in our day-to-day life. So when you come to the problem, then this is the solution that we are saying that in the psychological system, once you understand how it functions, then you are completely free here. Then you can focus in the external world actions.
if we are ready to accept the pain, then we can go through the pleasure.
Because we are accepting both pain, pleasure, everything here inside. We are not even trying to differentiate between pain, pleasure, etc. Because whatever happens here, we don't take responsibility. We don't own whatever is happening here. It is like, for example, if somebody is pressing the calling bell of my house, I have to go and attend and receive the visitor. Because somebody is pressing the calling bell of my house. But if somebody is pressing the bell of the next house, neighboring house, then I don't have to respond. I don't have to receive the visitor, right? So it is something similar to that. These thoughts and emotions and things, we are not creating. Because if you have the choice to create, if you have the right to create, you will create all pleasant emotions, right? Nobody will create negative, painful emotions, painful thoughts. I'll create all pleasant, positive thoughts, positive emotions only. If I have the choice, if I have the capability to do that. But we are not capable, unfortunately. We don't have any rights. We don't have any choice. It is happening on its own. Why do we have to own that? Why do we have to respond or take responsibility or ownership to that? Is what we are saying. We don't have to take ownership. And more than that, it is anyway going to die down. You're actually recognizing only at the time of its death. Almost it is about to die. You're recognizing that. And by trying to fight against it, you're giving life to that. And you're making it relive that emotion again and again and again. So the problem becomes bigger and bigger.
Why can't we enjoy the pleasure?
So there is nobody stopping you from enjoying the pleasure. You can always enjoy. There's no problem.
That's what I have,
sir. Yeah.
If the mind is seeking the pleasure, then we can enjoy the pleasure. No? That's what I'm asking.
If it is available to you, right? That's what we are saying. It may not be available to you always, right?
Okay.
And we are not worried about the pleasure point here, right? Pleasure, everybody, we know complaints. Only when there is a pain, that is what we are trying
to solve. Some people say, some spiritual people say, pleasure and pain are the coin of, is a same coin of both the sides.
Yes, correct.
If you seek a pleasure, you will have a pain also.
That is one way. Other way is, if you don't want pain, is also seeking pleasure, right? There is only two things. If you don't want pain, then which means you are asking for pleasure. You are seeking pleasure. So that's the pleasure-seeking nature of our, is what we say.
Okay. I don't think I am clear in this chapter. Okay, anyway, I will continue in this one.
Sure.
Again.
Sure, I think you have to go through it again and again. I mean, it
again
may not
and
be
again. Yeah, well, last 3 days I'm continuously interacting with the people
for 3 days. I mean,
I'm getting a little bit better.
Sure, go through that. If you have any doubts offline also, you can reach out, no problem.
Okay. Thank you. Okay,
muting now. Yeah, Krishna Sharma, we have added you in the group. Yeah, you can check up. Satyanarayan, you want to join? Can you tell me which place you are from? Just right there, we will add it to you. Hope you want in Tamil group or you want it in English group. That also you please write because you have written in Tamil. Satyanarayan. Yeah, Satyana, can you just answer? You want to get it added in English group or in Tamil group?
Ayya, vanakkam iya.
Vanakkam.
Kekudhungala nam pesuradhu.
Kekudhunga.
Ayya, enakku Tamil group la add panni kudunga.
Seringa, endha oorla irundhu pesuringa?
Na Coimbatore la irundhu pesuringa iya.
Seri, na add pandren.
Nandriya. Na idha modha murai na thodandhu YouTube la paathukittu irundhen. அப்புறம் இன்னைக்குதான் பேஸ்புக்ல போய் இந்த மீட்டிங்ல முத முறை இப்பதான் கலந்துருக்கிறேன். கேள்விகள் நான் நாளைக்கு நாளப்பின கேக்குறீங்கயா. நான் இந்த அமர்வுல உட்கார்னு எனக்கு ரொம்ப நாள் விருப்பம், அது உட்கார்ந்துருக்கிறேன். ரொம்ப நன்றிங்கய்யா.
ஓகே, நீங்க இந்த குரூப்ல சேர்ந்தவங்க உங்களுக்கு டெய்லி இன்டிமேஷன் வந்துடும், எத்தனை மணிக்கு மீட்டிங் இருக்கு, யாரு கண்டாக்ட் பண்றான், அதெல்லாம் வந்துடும். சோ நீங்க அப்பவே நீங்க இங்கிலீஷ்ல கேட்கலாம். ஓகே,
சரிங்க. பர்சனல் கேள்வி வந்து யார்ட்டிங்க கேட்கலாம்? சில ஒரு சில கேள்வி இருக்கு வந்துச்சுன்னா கேள்வி இங்க கேக்குறது யார்கிட்ட கேக்குறீங்கய்யா?
அந்த மாதிரி வந்தானா நீங்க வந்து உங்களுக்கு நம்பர் தரணும், அவங்ககிட்ட கேக்கலாம்.
சரி, நல்லதுங்க, சிறப்புங்க, நன்றிங்க.
இப்போதைக்கு உங்களுக்கு குரூப்ல ஆட் பண்ணிடுறோம், அந்த குரூப்ல ஆட் பண்ண பிறகு நீங்க அதலயே கேளுதலாம், யார்கிட்ட பர்சனல் கேள்வி கேட்கணும்னா அவங்களுக்கு பதில் வந்துடும்.
சரிங்க, சிறப்புங்க, ரொம்ப நன்றிங்க. நன்றி,
மீட் பண்றேன். Anybody who wants to ask the question, kindly raise your hands, use your hands options. Anand, today, okay, Senthil Jayabalan, he has given.
Okay.
I'm giving an unmute. Senthil Jayabalan, can you please tell from which place? Yeah.
Hey, this is Senthil. I'm from Bangalore.
Oh,
yeah,
hi.
Yeah. My question is, I read all IS books and the concept is understood.
Mm-hmm.
But as per the concepts, I don't have to ask for any changes in my mental state or anything.
Mm-hmm.
But still, in the background, my mind is expecting like I understood this, I should become calm or something.
Mm-hmm.
There is no changes even after knowing this concept for many years.
Mm-hmm.
So is it like here we are saying like we don't have to practice also, it's again understanding only.
Mm-hmm.
So many times also, even if you suppose like, for example, I'm getting anger. Right, in the angry, if I get short-tempered or getting anger, so sometimes like I feel like it is coming, but I should not control that. And we are saying like I cannot it's the expression is under my control from the end outside, but sometimes like without my understanding, I am expressing my anger.
Yeah.
But after like after once the anger is taking the control of me, so I am not able to again come back. So in those cases, after everything completed, I am understanding like something is like I should have controlled this little before, but again I'm not able to control. And even after understanding this concept, after many years, if my base is not changing, then I don't know how to use this understanding.
Yeah. Okay. So I think as I mentioned earlier as well, so in the external world, so you cannot be a perfect, you cannot expect that you will become a perfect human being after this understanding. That is not going to happen. Only thing is, you are always carrying this emotional baggage with you. You are always psychologically stuck. You are like a psychological slave, always slaves to your emotions and thoughts that were occurring in us. So you are like bounded. There was always a conflict and you were always fighting. So now that is freed. You are psychologically completely free. You will be able to enjoy that freedom. Once you are free, you will be, all your energy can be spent in the external world and you can be more efficient. You can operate in a much better way is what we are saying. With your limited capability, depending on your surroundings, so all that. So it cannot be that you will always be perfect, even against respect regarding your anger. Yes, sometimes, yes, it could be that you will come to know only after you express. Fine. So you have to only, probably try and be little calm or little patient next time. It is more of an external action, which you have to try and bring that practice in your side, yourself. Because it is more of the expression side, right? Anger will keep coming. The situation, if you feel that even that anger, only if you justify that, yes, this is, in this situation, I have the right to be angry. With this person, I have the right to be angry. Only if you justify, if your intellect justifies your anger, then only you will start expressing. You will be allowing that expression also to happen. Otherwise, if you don't justify, you will not do that. So that expression, yes, you will have to be a little bit calm and you will have to try and be patient. You'll have to handle it because if you feel that the other person is really important and very critical for you, the relationship with the other person, if you feel that importance, then obviously you will try and do in an amicable way, right? You will not simply shout and ignore, because only if you ignore or if you don't value that relationship, then only that, or sometimes because of freedom, because of your right or your freedom, because maybe you are having a good relationship. Also, that because of that also, you may freely express. You may want to freely express your emotions. That can also happen, right? So you have to only understand this more in how to express or how to apply, how to act in the external situation. Internally, anger and whatever comes, you know, we don't have any choice about that. So that you have to completely drop it. Hello.
Yeah. I got it again. Same explanation only. But I think this is not helping actually.
Yeah, the problem is when you say helping, there are two things. One is in the external situation, you are expecting that I should express in a much better way. That is one scenario. You are expecting that I should express in a better way or handle my anger in a better way. So that, yes, you have to be patient. You have to try multiple times, keep on trying. So only then that's going to happen. So that nobody says you will be perfect. So that is anyway clear, right? Coming to the internal, you are saying after understanding that psychologically nothing to do, then I'm not feeling that there is anything better means. So here we are saying better is also, you're again bringing some subtle form of emotion or some form of satisfaction that you have to feel, some form of an experience which will give you some satisfaction that, you know, I've understood or this is working for me. So that is again another demand that you're mind is giving, right? You are having another demand of, it's just another thought or another emotion. You can simply ignore that because we are saying that it will not act according to your own expectation, your own wish, right? So again, you cannot expect that peace or some kind of calm, because if you, the problem is once you start expecting, then again you start working against your own system, your own natural flow. You have to simply get defeated and accept everything as is. Even this understanding, even if you get a feeling that this is not helping me internally in the psychological system, that is also another thought. Accept that also, that's all. You cannot do anything. Is that... we got muted. He's in mute.
He's in mute. No?
Yeah. It's frozen. Oh,
those, okay. Yeah, okay. You think it's some problem there on the side. Okay, those who want to talk or discuss with Anand and raise the question, kindly use the hands raised option. Chandra Jayabalan has come, so I'm giving unmute.
Okay.
Yeah, Chandra, you can continue.
I got it. So again, yeah. same whatever like I heard earlier, I'll try that.
Uh-huh.
And
So what I suggest is probably, I mean, I don't know how much, we may not be able to spend too much time on this now because there's already, and others may have questions, etc. So what I can suggest is you can probably go through that book or whatever you are reading, and you can contact me as well. I can probably explain in detail. We can try and understand where exactly you are getting stuck. We can try to help.
Sure,
there.
Sir. So in this
you
case,
have my number,
it is
right?
Anger. No, I don't have your number. Maybe I'll...
Yeah,
I can take it from somebody, yeah.
Yeah, sure.
That's not an issue. So in this case, anger, the expression from like to outer world is with me.
Yes.
But if you take fear, right? So fear, it's automatically coming based on the situations or based on my prior experiences and all.
Yes.
I'm just letting that go again. I'm thinking like I'm not able to control. So, but still, I think it's keep on coming, right? So I think the intensity also is not reduced. Maybe my expectation to like after understanding it should reduce, but maybe also wrong. But still,
yes,
that expectation still keeps on there.
Yeah, still keep on coming means you don't want it to come, is it? You want it to come with a reduced effect, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, that is what it means, right? So that is exactly the problem, right? So you want your mind to act according to your expectation. And that is what we are saying, it will not. So that is where, see, once you start this expectation, then you're again indirectly, see, you have said that you are saying that you understood or you're not fighting, but indirectly you're again starting the same business. Just you're taking the back door, back entry, and doing the same thing again. That's the whole problem. That is why you will not.
Yeah, you are right, sir, but every whatever you learn, right, you have some expectation, right? I think it's also without our intention, it is coming.
Yes,
expectation also.
Yes. So if just allow it also, that is also fine. If it comes without your own this thing, that is fine. You don't try and create this expectation or try to have this expectation on your own. You don't try and do it on your own. That's all. If expectation also comes up on its own, fine, no problem.
See, sometimes I feel like I'm going on learning many things. My wife is not learning anything, and she's much better than me in emotional way or something. Then I'm thinking, like, what is the use of learning these things?
No. So I think some people maybe naturally also maybe able to handle it. You see, what we are saying finally here, are we saying something new? We're not saying anything new, because in the childhood, that is how we are. That is why we were. We were not catching hold of any of our emotions and thoughts. We were not trying to correct it. We were always like that in the childhood. Only after, when we grew up, we started having these rules and regulations. We started trying to regulate this mind. So we are saying, go back to your innocent childhood. Don't regulate, because mind is like this. That is what we are saying. So some people probably must have been always taking the casual approach of, you know, not taking their mind or these thoughts seriously. But again, it is only your view, right? You know, people from the externally, you know, you can say whatever you want about the other person, but other person may feel it differently also. We do not know what will the others feel about themselves or what kind of emotions or feelings they have. So that will be a different thing. You cannot keep that as a scale. So what I suggest is, I mean, you can go through and you can take my number and I can pinpoint where you're getting stuck. That is the problem. From what I understood, you're again trying to have this expectation indirectly. That is why it is not probably, you're not allowing it to flow and giving that freedom. That is why.
Any other question, please? Questions, kindly use your rights option.
Otherwise, it's already.
Yeah, it is already time up. So if there is no question, but today you have given some topic, Anand, right? Can you just tell some few lines about those friends, how to worries and how to get rid of them?
Okay. Fine. So whatever the topics or the answers may sound different, the questions, maybe all these questions, so many people are asking, right? All these questions may sound different, but underlying tone, if you see the root of all this is, how can I be happier? How can I be more happy? How can I be more satisfied? How can I bring in peace? So that's the whole point of all these, right? So the question is only one, actually. Even though the question may appear different, the root question or the root of all this is only one. So how can I be more happier? And that concept or the teaching is also only one. Though we are just trying to relate it by answering it in different ways and trying to give it related to that situation or that specific question, the answer is also only one. Psychologically, there is no target or nothing to achieve. There is no success here. We only have to get defeated, understand ourselves and get defeated. Then things which are the natural revelation flow, which was already there, in all of us, we will not disturb that, and all our sorrows, worries, everything will get taken care of its own. So that is the underlying concept. So though we put it in different words to make it relate to the question, but the whole underlying truth or the concept is only one. So probably that is what we are trying to say in different words.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you. So we will close the session now. Yep. Okay. So 1 minute, somebody has put in chat. Any question is there? Okay. He has preceded us. So I thank Anand on behalf of all of you.
Thank you.
For the session is concerned. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So I am stopping the recording.